Hi all. Today we are going to see an important concept in network security, that is cryptography and message authentication. First of all, we'll go for the concept called cryptography. Before which, why do we need cryptography? So, now in this diagram, we can see what is the concept behind cryptography is. Or what is the purpose of having cryptography is. First of all, you can see that the sender wishes to send any data to the receiver. Here, the sender is sending is a plain text, and this particular plain text cannot be sent as such in the open network. So what we have to do is, this particular plain text has to be converted into some unreadable format, and we call that unreadable format, we call that as a ciphertext. So the process of converting the plain text into a ciphertext, which means that is unreadable format, we call that as encryption. And this particular encrypted data will be transferred, or that will be communicated through the open network, and it reaches the receiver network, where this particular ciphertext is being converted into a plain text. We call this process as decryption, that will be handled in the receiver network. This particular process of encryption and decryption, we call that as cryptography. Cryptography plays a very important role in securing the data in an open network. And now here we are going to see more about why we need cryptography is and what we can do with the cryptography is. We are having two types of cryptography. One is symmetric key, the other one is asymmetric. Symmetric key cryptography, which is also called as conventional or secret key cryptography. And this secret key is shared between the sender and receiver. So, to perform encryption and decryption, we need a secret key, and if it is going to be a single secret key for both encryption and decryption, we call that cryptography as symmetric key cryptography. And the next one is asymmetric cryptography, where you are going to use two different keys for encryption and decryption, public key and private key. One for encryption, the other for decryption. Any key can be used to perform any process, that is either encryption for encryption can be used with the public key and decryption with private key. Now this particular figure gives what are all the elements that is being used in public key encryption is. So, plain text, encryption algorithm, public key and private keys, ciphertext and decryption algorithm. So, as I have already told you, what do you mean by plain text is nothing but the original message that the sender wishes to send. So, that is what plain text is. And the encryption algorithm, we need an algorithm in order to convert the plain text into ciphertext, for which we need keys. In case of public key encryption, we need two different keys, that is public and private key. Usually this public and private key will be a pair, and the next one is ciphertext, is nothing but the unreadable code of your plain text is called a ciphertext. And by using this encryption algorithm and public and private keys, we can convert that plain text into ciphertext. And with regard to decryption algorithm, your plain text is being generated from the ciphertext by using some decryption algorithm, for which again we have to use either public or private key for this process. Essential steps in public key cryptography. So in order to perform public key cryptography, what are all the steps that the user has to do? Each user generates a pair of keys to be used for encrypting and decrypting the message. Each user places one of the key in the public register that can be accessed by others. If B wishes to send a private message to A, B encrypts a message using A's public key. When A receives a message, decrypts it using her private key. No other can decrypt the message, as the private key is known only by A. The next concept called message authentication. It is a procedure that allows the communicating parties to verify that received messages are authentic, which means whenever we are receiving any message, we have to identify that whether the message is an unaltered or unmodified data. To perform this, we have to make two important aspects to be done in message authentication. One is to verify that the content of the message have not been altered and the source is authentic. Source is nothing but from where you have received the message, that is the sender. Whether the sender is the original sender or not, the source should be authentic as well as the message should not be altered. These two cases has to be identified in order to trust the message that we have received. So in order to perform the message authentication, we are having some methods as listed here: conventional encryption, authentication without using message encryption, for which we are having two methods: message authentication code, the other one is one-way hash function. First of all, we'll see conventional encryption. So message authentication can be done with the help of conventional encryption. So as I have already told you, what do you mean by conventional encryption is also nothing but the symmetric key cryptography, where you have used a single key for both encryption and decryption. And here we are not going for encryption and decryption. Here we are going to use the same concept for message authentication, where we are having some slight modifications. A common key called a session or secret key is shared by both the sender and receiver. So encryption, as I have already told you, the plain text will be converted into ciphertext and that will be performed in the sender side, and the decryption at the receiver side will be performed using the same secret key. This secret key used should be shared among the sender and receiver before the session gets started. And error reduction codes can also be added to improve the authentication. So next one is without using encryption, that is by using message authentication code. So here we are not going to use any encryption methods, but even then we have to identify that the message is an authenticated message or not. Here we are going to concentrate only on the message authentication, where you have to trust that, or we have to ensure that the message that we have received is the original message or not, or is unaltered message or not. So for which we are going to use a message authentication code concept. This is these following steps has to be taken. First one, the communicating parties share a common secret key KAB, let it be. When A has a message to send to B, it calculates a MAC. MAC is nothing but message authentication code as a function of a message and the key. And here we have defined how to generate a MAC. MAC for a message M can be generated with the function F, where it carries KAB, M. M is your original message and that will be taken into a function along with the key, and it will be generated with MAC. The message plus the generated code are transmitted to the intended recipient. The received code is compared to calculated code. Now you can see in this diagram how the message authentication code gets generated is. A secret key is used to generate a small block of data, that is the MAC, which is appended to the message by the sender. So you can see in this diagram, the message is passed through the MAC algorithm along with the key, secret key K, and you are going to generate MAC, and that particular MAC is being attached with the message and it is being transmitted. At the receiver end, the message and the received MAC will be received, and you'll be having your message to be again passed to MAC algorithm along with the same key K, and it will be generated again a MAC code. The received MAC and the calculated MAC should be the same. If both are same, then your message, we can trust that the message is an unaltered message or else unmodified message, so the message is authentic. Next method is one-way hash function. A hash function accepts a variable size message m as input and produces a fixed size message digest h of m as output. Unlike MAC, a hash function does not take a secret key as input. There are three ways to check the message authenticity here. So either you can use a conventional encryption, public key encryption, or using secret value. So first one is by using conventional encryption. So the source A, let it be A, and the destination be B. So from A, if a message has to be passed, the message will be passed to a hash function where a hash value gets generated according to the message, and the hash value will be encrypted with the help of a key K, and the encrypted hash value we call that as message digest or digital signature. This message digest will be attached with the message and it is being transmitted. At the destination end, this message again it takes into a hash function and it gets generated with the hash value. The attached hash value and the generated hash value will be compared and it will be identified whether that particular message is an authentic message or not. The next methodology is one-way hash function using public key encryption. Both the conventional encryption and public key encryption, the methodology is going to be the same, but the only difference here is the key usage. In conventional encryption, we have used only one single key both for encrypting and for decrypting your hash value. Here, we are going to use encrypting the hash value by using a private key, and for decrypting, we'll be using a public key. So, the message is passed to the hash function to generate a hash value, and the hash value gets encrypted by using the private key, and the encrypted hash value, which is called as digital signature, will be attached with the message and it gets transmitted. At the receiver end, the message again it will be passed to the hash function to generate a message digest, and then the received message digest will be again decrypted with the help of a public key and it will be generated with the hash value. The generated hash value and the received hash value should be compared, and only if both are the same, then we can trust the message as an unaltered message, so that we can have a message authentication has been implemented here. The last function, or as in our last methodology, is called as a one-way hash function using secret value. Here the same concept, but we are not going to use any keys. Instead, we are going to use some secret value, and this secret value will be generated along with the message. And the message and the secret value will be an assumed value. So this particular entire block gets hashed and will be generated with the hash value. And that hash value will be attached with the message and it gets transmitted. And at the receiver end, the message along with the secret value will be again, it gets into a hash function to generate the hash value. The attached hash value and the generated hash value is again compared to verify the message authentication. So in order to identify that the message is being unaltered message or a original message, in order to identify that, we are having these functions. So then, thank you. So you'll be getting an idea what is a cryptography is and how to have the message to be authenticated and how to identify whether the message is an authenticated message or not from this session. So thank you again for watching this session. Thank you.